Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can
try to look for the flash, that high post flash, whether it's on against man or zone. But Drexel doing a really good job of fighting over top of the post players trying to establish position near the block.
Jade Chapman in, Makeda Nicholas out. Delaware ball in the forecourt, moving left to right here. Gonzalez out near center court. Up top to Anabosi. High post give to Chapman. Looks opposite corner. Brown open three. Front rim no. Chapman and Anabosi collide for the rebound. Chapman got it, then was stripped by Woods. And Drexel ends up with the ball.
I thought that was great execution on the offensive end by Delaware. Really good ball movement, just didn't hit the shot.
They're getting the open looks. Got to be able to knock them down from the perimeter. Also got to be careful not to fall in love with a three against that zone. Creighton dribbling towards the lane, out to Curran near wing. She goes to the foul line, nowhere to go from there. Back out to Creighton left wing. Into the corner, Pellecchio. Her pass stolen away by the fronting Gonzalez. She spins, works her way into the forecourt, angles towards the lane, all the way to the bucket, was fouled, and will head to the line to shoot two. Gonzalez showing a little extra acceleration there.
Yeah, I really like the decision because she did have some people running in the lane, but I love the decision. Go and attack, and that's something we haven't seen a ton from her. A little bit on some steals, but I like that she went all the way to the rim.
First free throw good for Abby Gonzalez. Now 12 of 17 from the stripe on the season. The foul goes to Pellecchio, her first, second on Drexel. 3:04 left opening quarter. One more foul shot coming for Gonzalez, and she ties the game at 8. So a battle, exactly what you would expect. Delaware third in the CAA. Drexel 4. Hens 13-8 overall. Drexel 15-6. Here's Greenberg top of the circle. Near wing Curran fires the three. That one's good. Chapman gave her space. You can't do that against Sarah Curran.
Yeah, you can't do that against a lot of these Drexel players. I mean, if you give them any room at all, they are launching that three-point shot. They use a jump stop, no, always a 1-2 step, so it's quicker.
Curran, Pellecchio, and Creighton especially, you have to get up in their grill. Brown, foul line right, up top Jardine. Reverse it left wing to Gonzalez. Entry feed to Chapman, back out Jardine. Right wing three would not go. Weak side rebound up high to grab it. Sarah Woods in traffic. Outlets it forward to Creighton, who walks it up.
It really, Delaware is getting great looks. They're just not knocking them down right now. And a different philosophy on offense. Drexel with the jump stops, Delaware with a 1-2 step.
Enzo of three from deep, 2 of 9 overall. Woods top of the circle, fouled by Anabosi. Reaching in, and that's one. Got to be careful to avoid if you're Anabosi. That's how you end up in foul trouble and over on the bench.
Yeah, and Drexel's really good at making adjustments as well. Denise Dillon, you know her plan of attack is to attack those post players, especially Nicole Anabosi.
Good news for Delaware, only her first, team's first. Hens have not made a field goal in 5.5 minutes. Curran on the inbound, fouled by Kiri West, who just came in the game, and to get the hand check call against West. The nickel dimer, something we had not seen much of in the first 8 minutes.
And that, you know, we were talking about letting them play. I didn't even see her hand on her. I thought she bodied her up, if anything.
Lob inbound goes to Curran, hands it to Creighton, back to Curran in the corner. Circles towards the top of the key, picks up her bounce, hands there to Greenberg. Greenberg back to Creighton, foul line left in the corner near side Woods. Woods puts it on the deck, works her way to the paint, tries to draw contact, no call, just threw it up in the air, and Anabosi ends up with it. Brings it up herself, weaves through traffic, and stripped out of bounds. It'll stay with the Hens. Good hands for the freshman, Aubrey Brown.
I thought that was fantastic defense by Delaware. Erica Brown cutting off Greenberg, not allowing her to get the ball, and then Delaware doing a great job of fronting down low on the block. Just a great defensive set, causing Drexel to take an out-of-control shot.
They bring in freshman Anna Ferrariu from Romania, 5'9". Romanian national team player. Here's West inside the arc off one dribble. Her jumper, no good for the corner. Weak side rebound grabbed by Crick. Final 90 seconds of the opening quarter. Ferrariu with it near wing. Up top to Creighton. Creighton puts it on the deck, dribbling towards the right wing. Picks up her bounce to Ferrariu, top of the circle. Left-hand dribble towards the lane. Spins back. Backdoor cut. Brown wide open. Lays it home. Great movement without the ball. It's 13-8 Drexel.
If you don't jump to the ball on the line, up the line, and jump, Drexel will cut right behind you on a slip.
Final minute now of the opening period. Hens have not made a field goal in more than 6 minutes and 20 seconds. Gonzalez near wing towards the top. High post entry to Anabosi. Head fake, step back, 16-footer, swish! Nicole Anabosi with it range. Delaware back to within 3.
And I think Delaware's got to find a way. They're getting really good looks, but I'd like to see them get around the rim a little bit more and attack. Try to get to the free throw line.
16-second differential shot and game clock. Ferrariu, top of the circle, working her way right of the lane, picks up the bounce. Opposite wing look for Kern. Her three is good. West couldn't get back in time. Second three for Kern. 6-point Drexel lead. Final 20 seconds of the opening quarter.
Closeout so important. You just can't sink too low. You can't close out on Drexel.
13 seconds to go. Brown operating near wing off the bounce. 8 seconds, she picked up her dribble, lobs to Jardine, left-hand dribble towards the elbow, into the corner, West, open, triple, that one's good! Big shot, Kerry West! To end the opening quarter, they'll say her toe was on the line for a 2, but Delaware down just 4 after 1. It's Drexel 16, Delaware 12. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
Brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at
$22,500. What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Let me get a mix pick two.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. Mick Pick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
22. Kerry West hitting a jumper, though, to end the opening period, giving Delaware a little bit of momentum. And you know what, Christine? Considering the fact that Delaware shot just 33% in that first quarter, you can live with being down only 4.
I think so, but I think something we spoke about in the pregame about guarding that perimeter, 12 of Drexel's 16 points coming from behind the arc, 3-point line.
4 of 6. 5 of the 6 shots have been wide open. That's something that has to be fixed. You're absolutely right. So it's Drexel ball moving right to left to start the second quarter. Creighton giving far wing to Greenberg. Swing it near wing. Ferrariu beats Jardine off the bounce and lays it home. Plus a foul. Nicholas rotated over late. And an and one opportunity for the Romanian freshman.
And that's a mistake we actually haven't seen come up in the last few games. If she's got that layup, okay, go for that block if you're going to leave your feet, but you can't kind of hit her after she lets go of that ball. Kind of a silly foul there because now you're giving her a free extra point.
You can watch it on film. You don't realize it until you see it in person as Ferrariu misses the free throw. Rebound grab by Anabosi. The freshman has a good left hand. You better guard her left side. That was a heck of a move. Here's Green. Gonzalez across the timeline. Near wing give to Nicholas. Into the corner to Jardine. Up top to Brown. Brown puts it on the deck. Matchup zone still for Drexel. Brown dribbling between the rings. 10 on the timer. Delaware really not doing much. Brown tries to create off the bounce. Pull up jumper from the elbow. Wouldn't go. Rebound Creighton over the back foul against Jardine. And so it'll be Drexel ball here. First team foul on Delaware in the second quarter. And this is what Tina Martin talked about pregame. You have to guard against frustration for Drexel. There's going to be ebbs and flows. It's a game of runs. Can't get down on yourself if things don't go well.
Yeah, and these games are usually in the 50s, the Drexel-Delaware game. But Delaware not recognizing. Actually, Drexel was in a man-to-man there. They switched that defense up.
There's a three. Creighton straight away. That one's good. And it's 21-12. 9-point lead, 9:08 to go in the second quarter. You're right, it was, man, was switching on everything, and Delaware kind of just stood around, which is why I assumed they went zone.
And I think Drexel's doing a really nice job here, frustrating the Hens, even with the full court pressure.
Brown trying to drive to the basket, threw it up off the window way too hard. Rebound Pellecchio. She'll bring it across the timeline. Pellecchio stopping top of the key, working right wing, bounce pass to Creighton, dribbles up top, leaves for Greenberg, foul line left. Greenberg yet to put on the deck, just gives it back to Creighton. Creighton head fake to three to Ferrariu. Ferrariu dribbling between the circles, now angling towards the Delaware bench, working her way right of the lane, missing the runner. Rebound grab in traffic by Greenberg, and Drexel will get another opportunity.
Wow, Greenberg came flying over the top there and just willed that rebound into her hands.
Creighton far wing towards the corner, picks up her bounce, gives to Greenberg, top of the key. Greenberg hands it to Creighton, left-hand bounce into the lane, layup blocked by Nicholas. She tipped it off the hands of a teammate, but it'll go out of bounds and stay with the Dragons, 10 to shoot. Chapman back, and Abosi out for Delaware. Feels like an important defensive stop, though, because Drexel has pretty much all the momentum right now and trying to get the lead to double digits.
Exactly, and I think, you know, Tina Martin using a very short bench right now. She's only played seven players, and it took a little bit in that first quarter for her to even substitute.
No Bailey Cargo yet. Inbound Pellecchio gives it back to the inbounder, Creighton, driving baseline on Brown. Good defense. Forced the pass over to Curran. Curran driving to the paint. Layup good, plus a foul. West tried to slide over and take the charge, was there late, and it's an and-one opportunity coming for Sarah Curran.
You know, and this is a big difference. You know, over this six-game winning streak here, Delaware has jumped out on a lot of teams, and this is the first time in a few games that Delaware has had to dig out of a hole. They've done it earlier in the season. They've been able to come back and win some of those games, so they have that to go back to, but this is something we haven't seen during the winning streak.
Curran's free throw is good, 24-12. Drexel doubling up Delaware. 8 minutes left, first half. Hens got to find something on the offensive end. They're just 4 of 14 for the field. West, far wing, up top, Nicholas, lobbing high post to Chapman. Chapman, near corner to Brown. Brown driving into traffic, kicks it out to West, head fake to two, and got tackled by Creighton, who fell for the head fake and landed on poor Keary West. Everybody up and all right. First foul on Creighton, first foul on Drexel in the second quarter.
And that was a really good fake because you don't often see Drexel trying to block perimeter shots, and she got Creighton flying in the air.
Inbound goes to Chapman, left wing, up top Gonzalez, right wing to West, around the perimeter, near corner to Brown. Brown trying to get it inside to Chapman, can't find her, up top to West, left wing Nicholas. Into the corner, Gonzalez, her entry feed stolen. Bad pass, bad seal, Greenberg got the theft. Here comes Creighton the other direction, leaves for Curran, back to Creighton in the corner, driving on Brown, offensive foul. Erica Brown beat her to the spot, and that's two fouls in the span of about 20 seconds. On Drexel point guard Megan Creighton.
And that's huge because as Drexel goes, she goes. I thought she extended the arm. I thought Erica was playing really good defense. But Megan Creighton is so valuable to this team. She has a ton of assists, not many turnovers, and she can score in bunches as well. Just the leader of this team. Her and Curran, for the last 4 years, have been what Drexel's been about.
West and Chapman to the bench. Anabosi back in. Jardine returning as well. Nicholas, high, low lob, inside left block, Anabosi lays it home. Delaware back to within 10.
What a great dive there by Anabosi to recognize that. And I think Delaware needs to get back to basics and start pounding it in. And the post players need to really establish, and they got to get it in on the block.
Ferrario dribbling near wing, working on Anabosi, lobbing opposite corner. Pellecchio, three is deep. Woods, though, the weak side rebound over Gonzalez. Finds Ferrario in the center of the lane, kicks it out right wing Brown, and that's going to be a 3-second call. Ferrario never left the paint, and the Hens get the ball back.
Yeah, I thought a pretty good defensive set there for Delaware. They didn't get that rebound, but it was way over the top of Abby Gonzalez's head, so fortunate to get that ball back and see if they can cut this back into single digits.
Sarah Curran asked the official if she could please tie her shoe, then said thank you after she let her do it. I love that politeness. And now a 3-second violation the other way. Nicholas wanted the ball in the post from Anabosi. Didn't get it. Got to leave. Did not. And so the ball goes back to Drexel. Ferrario just fell down away from the ball. Her shoe was untied. She's just going to sit there and tie it as we play on. 20 on the shot clock, 6:22 left. She just lost her footing. Now she goes down again. Pellecchio gives the three and hits it from the near wing. Timeout, Tina Martin. Dragons falling left and right. The teammates just kept playing. They hit the tray, and Tina Martin is not pleased. Take the timeout with the Hens head coach. 6:13 left, second quarter. Drexel 27, Delaware 14. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOB.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150
that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart. Moving forward. It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Gained a little momentum near the end of the opening quarter, but it has been all Drexel here in this second period. Delaware just calling a timeout down. 27-14, almost nothing has gone right in the second period.
And I think this is one of those situations when you're just trying to chip away and win the next 6 minutes and close out well, because you don't want this thing to get out of hand. But Drexel just shooting the lights out, 50% from the field and 67% from behind the arc.
So Delaware ball out of their call timeout. Gonzalez far wing. Up top, Anabosi threw it away. Tried to force it inside for Nicholas. Drexel was ready for it, and it's stolen by Brown. Brown feeds it forward to Curran. Near corner, Pellecchio open, triple good. And it's 30-14. They are raining trays. 7 of 10 from deep.
Yeah, Delaware has got to get out on the three-point line. They have to close out better.
Gonzalez far wing up top to Brown. They also need to stop turning the ball over offensively. Here's Brown working her way towards the paint. High off the window, no good. Nicholas follows, stripped all the way up. Brown got it back, and she was fouled. And we'll head to the line to shoot two. I like Erica Brown being aggressive on the offensive end, but the shot's just not falling for her here in the early going.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great take, and it was just a hair off on the backboard. I mean, we've seen her make that shot 100 times, but I like the plan of attack. I like getting to the rim, get to the free throw line, try to chip away at the lead.
First foul shot around and out, though. Brown not getting to the line this season as much as she has in the past. This is just her 50th foul shot attempted on the year. One more line right for the senior out of Patterson, New Jersey. Bends the knees, puts the shot up, and off the mark. Two big misses. The deficit remains at 16. The foul, by the way, on Ferrario, her first, team's third. Far wing, it's Brown. Up top to Curran. Curran driving towards the paint. Pull-up jumper blocked by Anabosi. Woods, though, got it in the lane. Kicked it out to Curran. Curran. Double team. They reset the shot clock. That ball never hit the rim. So the shot clock should not be at 26. 5:14 left second quarter. We'll see what they move the timer to.
They'll probably have to go to the monitor to see what it was when they reset.
11. They were on top of it.
Well, there you go.
The shortest delay we've seen this season.
I thought it's been a pretty well-officiated game thus far.
I agree. Brown to the bench. Gonzalez back in. Kerry West guarding balls. The inbound goes to Pellecchio. Works her way to the lane. Spinning back out to Ferrario. Deep two from the corner. Wouldn't go. West tipped the rebound. Jardine sprawling on the floor after it. Tying up Aubrey Brown. Good news is it's Delaware ball. Bad news is the Hens lose the arrow. They are not doing a very good job on the glass.
Yeah, and that was one of the keys to our game. Not only rebounding, but especially those long rebounds. The other key to the game was perimeter defense, especially defense up near the three, not sinking in too low, being able to close out, and then being able to trail. And Delaware in those two key areas not doing as good of a job as they need to be.
Drexel has six offensive rebounds already in the early going. That's one of the big reasons why Delaware down 16. Nicholas at the free throw line. Fadeaway is good. Tough shot, but it goes 30-16.
Yeah, Hens need to get back to that high-low pass, pound it in the paint, and then move, pass and move, pass and move.
And they also have got to find a way to hit a perimeter jumper. They're just packing the zone in, making life tough. Ferrario out near center court, near wing give to Brown. Baseball pass across the floor to Curran. Her three over Jardine is an air ball deep. Woods ends up with it. Head fake and banks it home for the left block. It's 32-16.
And that's just the killer on the weak side on the rebound. Man, and it seemed like Curran actually was able to kind of read the lettering on the ball before she got that up.
Anabosi at the free throw line. Right wing give Gonzalez. Big three, no good. Rebound, ooh, Kerry West got drilled by Nikita Nicholas and hit the deck hard. Hopefully she's all right. Came down awkwardly. And she is down. The training staff will go check on Kerry West. Not sure what hit first, but West grimacing as the athletic training staff out to check on her. It was Nikita Nicholas that collided with West. They actually called a foul on Bailey Greenberg. That's unfortunate for Drexel, and Denise Dillon asking who they call the foul on, because it was Nicholas that hit her, but right now the worry is with West that she's all right.
Yeah, it looked to me she was horizontal in midair and smashed down on her hip and back area. I mean, she was flat and had no ability to brace herself with her hand. So, I mean, it seems like she'll be okay, but man, someone who has some back issues, that hurt me just watching it, so hopefully she'll be okay. But I do agree. I thought, you know, McKenna Nicholas actually was the one who hit her. So for Drexel, that's, I think, Denise Dillon trying to plead her case there. We'll get another look at it here on the replay. She went up, and, I mean, Kelly Greenberg was in the vicinity, but it was McKenna Nicholas that hit her.
That's a tough call.
Yeah.
Hens All Access crew doing a good job if you're watching online. The inbound goes far corner to McKenna Nicholas. Nicholas dribbling towards the wing, picking up her bounce, lobbing left elbow to Anabosi. One dribble back in the corner to Nicholas. Back to Anabosi, and a foul as Woods went through her body to tip the pass, and that'll send Anabosi to the free throw line to shoot a pair.
Great little two-man game right there with Makeda Nicholson and Anabosi going inside out, allowing Nicole Anabosi to reestablish. And I like that Makeda Nicholas didn't, not panic, but didn't feel that urgency to have to take that shot, but they were able to play catch a little bit, and Nicole Anabosi again working so hard to reestablish.
Hens down 16, 3:55 left to go in the opening half. First free throw is good. It hit the rim five times, finally fell through. Christine, it does seem like Drexel are doing a good job of forcing Delaware's bigs off the block. That catch was 10, 15 feet from the basket.
I think they are doing a good job of that. And when they are down low, Drexel's fighting over the top, and Delaware not able to get that lob in because the weak side help from Drexel is there, so they're kind of sandwiching the post players.
And that weak side help able to be there because Delaware not making threes, so no need to play modest. And Anabosi hits a pair back to within 14. Just got to chip away and try to get this to single digits at the half.
And that's why it's so important to be a threat from the perimeter, because if not, they're going to kind of give you that shot until you start beating them from that area.
Brown picking up her bounce well away from the basket, giving far corner to Greenberg. Back to Brown. Spins towards the top of the key. Picks up her dribble again in a bad spot. Finds Pellecchio. Deep three from the right wing. Short. Weak side rebound. Grabbed by Anabosi. Nice board. Outlets it up to Brown. Looking to push across the timeline. Inside the top of the key. Backing up. Left wing give now to Anabosi. Dribbles to the free throw line. Left wing Dardine. Entry feed to Nicholas. Turnaround jumper off the mark. Pellecchio the ball.
Yeah, a little too far out there for the fadeaway jump shot. I'd love to see her give a little show and go. Fake the shot, put it once hard on the ball, on the floor, and just go right to the rim.
And Nicholas is capable of that. We've seen her score off the dribble. Here's Brown near wing. Into the corner to Ferrario. Ferrario dribbling towards the top. Gonzalez all over her. She turns the corner towards the lane. Scoops one high off the window. No good. Anabosi tipped the rebound. Brown ends up with it. Dribbled off the foot. I thought we were going to have the ball. It's going to be just out of our reach. It's going to be Maggie Hayon who has to get up and get it.
Well, I saw you put your hand out, but I guess your depth perception's a little off here in your older age because you weren't even close to that.
I realized that I am connected by cable to not be able to reach and get the ball. Wow. Oh, man. So age is on the table again. Jardine up top, dribbling left wing, handing to Brown. Brown backing up in front of the Drexel bench, working her way to the free throw line, crossing over, left of the lane, spinning back to Jardine, into the corner, Brown, high arcing triple, front rim, no, Nicholas tipped the rebound off the hands of Drexel, then off the fingertips of Aubrey Brown. Hens will get a fresh 30.
Yeah, and age was only on the table because you brought it up Friday night on that broadcast.
I'm too old to remember that, Christine. Inbound will cut baseline left from Gonzalez. Looking, still looking, lobbing for Anabosi. Nice catch by Nicole. Delaware with the ball, down by 14. Handing to Brown, dribbling right wing into the corner. Gonzalez, driving baseline. Leaves it off left block Nicholas. Her shot just caroms off the window. Curran grabs the board.
Yeah, really good pass there by Abby Gonzalez to swing through, go down the baseline. The help comes and steps up, and she made a great pass to McKenna Nicholas opposite block.
Brown pirouetting her way to the far wing, giving there to Curran. Up top, Greenberg. Swing it left wing, Ferrario. Puts it on the deck with the right hand. Crosses back to the left. Nice entry feed to Greenberg. Lefty bank is good. And it's 34-18. Clinic put on there by Drexel.
And Drexel's really doing what Delaware wants to do. They're posting up, beating them from now in the second quarter from the block.
Brown got stripped on her way to the basket. Nicholas ended up with it and got it inside to Anabosi, who's called for the walk. Turnover gives it back to Drexel, up 16. 100 seconds remaining in the opening half. Brown and Anabosi out. Bailey Cargo in for the first time. Chapman also returning. Delaware needs to find some sort of an answer offensively.
Yeah, I think Tina Martin putting in Bailey Cargo, seeing if she can maybe get something going from the perimeter.
Ferrario dribbling between the rings. Very tough half so far for Delaware. Bad pass off the leg of Greenberg, but she gets it back. Drives on Jardine, scoops it home. Tina Martin wanted a walk, but that's a nice move.
Yeah, Delaware in danger here. Down 18 points. Boy, it really ballooned here in the second quarter.
Yeah, saying you wanted to get it within single digits, had their chance, couldn't score, and now it's gone the other direction. 105 to go. Jardine in the corner. Left wing to Cargo. Opposite look. Gonzalez, big triple. Got it, Abby Gonzalez for the right wing. Back to 15.
And that's a big shot because if Delaware can get a stop here and and then get something down on the offensive end. Then it's more manageable when you make adjustments at halftime.
Boy, did they need that shot. Now a stop and a score. You take momentum to the break. Ferrario, left wing, puts it on that right hand towards the top. Timeout called by Denise Dillon. But Ferrario really can handle with the right and left hand. She's got a smooth game. She's a little older than your typical freshman. She's played on the Romanian U16, U18, and U20 team over the course of her career.
And just having that experience, having that international experience, being a little bit older and now coming into a well-established team, just another weapon for Denise Dillon's team. But Denise Dillon, not liking what she saw there, knows how important, even for Drexel, this possession is, because they can kind of, you know, get a little bit more separation, knowing if they don't get anything here, Delaware with an opportunity to cut into this lead and make it more manageable in the third quarter.
13 left on the shot clock for Drexel. Remember, Delaware has been a good come-from-behind team this year. Erased a huge deficit against George Mason, double digits in the second half. We're down 26 against Detroit. Came back and tied the game in the fourth quarter, even though they couldn't win it. But you want some momentum heading into the locker room. Kern will throw the ball in from just in front of our broadcast position, near sideline, between the rings to Brown. Brown, bounce pass, left wing, Pelecchio, wide open, triple, wouldn't go. Nicholas tipped the rebound. Greenberg had it, lost it. Nicholas grabbed it from her backside. Jardine grabs the ball. She's fat in the backcourt, and a walk the length to shoot a pair. And that's a good break for Delaware. Hannah Jardine is the Hens best free throw shooter, although she was flexing that right ankle a little bit as she got rolled up. And that's the third foul on Pelecchio. Oh, how big is that?
And how about Makeda Nicholas on that possession? Comes flying in, almost looked kind of like Kerry West did, got taken out on the ground, gets the ball and passes it out to try to save that possession. Great hustle.
So two free throws coming for Jardine off the mark with the first. A career better than 85% foul shooter. 8 of 12 now for the season. That was a fantastic rebound, though. You're so right by Nicholas. Ended up with it on her backside after it volleyballed around. Second free throw, a swish, and it's 36-22. So a 14-point game. Need to dig in defensively. Shot clock off for Drexel.
Yeah, and you know Drexel is going to utilize every second of this last possession. Delaware needs to get stopped.
Ferrario dribbling far wing, now towards the top. 12 seconds left. She's been running point with Creighton out with two fouls. Gets it back between the rings from Curran. Gives off to Brown. Brown drives the lane, kicks to Curran. Left corner three is a swish. It's 39-22. No momentum into the locker room for Delaware. Big triple by Curran off the dribble penetration. And that is the end of the first half. Delaware just not stopping the ball on the perimeter, and it's breaking down their whole defense.
And then they're helping in situations where they either should not be helping or they're sinking too low. Curran, all she did was run on the baseline, and there was no one trailing her. Got to trail shooters. Basketball 101, trail shooters off screens.
Tall task in front of the Hens after 20 minutes. Drexel 39, Delaware 22. We'll send it to Ronnie Vickers, who will have our Blue Hens halftime report. It's presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. It comes your way next. Delaware down 17 at the half.
Brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow.
I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Love me, get a big pick two. Can I big pick two?
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at
$22,500. What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Let me get a mix pick two. It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. Mick pick two for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi.
But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow.
I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow.
I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
The post defense of fighting to get in front, and you know they have had tendencies too. You gotta hope that they miss a few too, that they go on a little bit of a cold streak and you get some stops.
Second half begins with Drexel moving left to right. Dragons ball and a turnover. Trying to lob it inside. It was tipped away by Nicholas, stolen by Brown, but then stolen right back as Brown tried to drive Aubrey Brown. Stole it from Kerr, and here come the Dragons.
Yeah, I thought Drexel kind of forced that into Curran, but there they go again. We know what they're trying to look for here.
Wow, Curran caught it high post. Back into Anabosi away from the basket. And they called a foul against Anabosi, so Curran gets two free throws, and that's a heady little play there to just feel the defender off balance and create the contact herself.
Yeah, and I was actually surprised because usually when she comes off those screens, she goes right to the rim, either from the right or the left. So it was actually pretty interesting that she kind of stopped to fade away there. And Nicole Nabosi with a, that's a tough foul.
Second free throw after the first was good, is good as well. And it's 41-22, so the lead grows now up to 19 for Drexel.
And then you see Drexel still picking up full court and then settling back into their half-court defense. So now Delaware just getting into their offensive set with 20 seconds left in the shot clock.
Anabosi high post, lob over the top. Nicholas on the left block, missed the bunny. Then tipped the rebound into the corner, sprawling to the bench to try to save it. Can't keep it in. Good hustle But a point-blank miss, and the frustration continues for UD.
And it seemed like Sarah Curran took a shot in the nose. I feel like every time she plays in this building, she gets hit in the face. I think, remember last year, she really took a shot to her nose.
I couldn't believe it didn't break. She was in all types of pain. Was trying to show the official the big bump on her nose because they didn't even call a foul on it. Here's Creighton, top of the circle, dribbling near wing, giving to Greenberg. A three would not go. Long rebound tipped by Brown. Creighton ended up with it. Brown stole it away from the deck. Passes it forward to Gonzalez. One on four. Good decision to spin off. Dishes inside to Anabosi into the corner. Gonzalez open triple. Hit the top of the backboard. Rebound grabbed by Woods.
Right pass, though. I mean, that's the extra pass. That's not a horrible look if you can knock that down.
She just rushed it.
Yeah.
Everything is in fast forward right now. Drexel's defense frustrating Delaware. Woods pushing off on Brown. Erica takes the charge. The ball goes back to Delaware. But a minute 34 into the second half and still have not scored, and their deficit has grown to 19.
Yeah, Delaware really needs to pound that into the paint. You know, McKenna Nichols had a great look two possessions ago, just could not finish the layup. You got to make layups when you're trying to fight to get back into a game.
Gonzalez, bounce pass, top of the circle to Anabosi. Anabosi driving past Brown into the corner. Gonzalez, three around and out. Much better looking shot, still didn't get the roll. Here comes Drexel the other way. Up 19 with the ball, Creighton in no hurry, stopped to the midcourt strike.
But what I like about Abby Gonzalez is that she took the shot again. She didn't shy away from it. I just missed one, took a bad shot. She got back into it again. I like the confidence.
Far wing on the dribble, it's Aubrey Brown towards the top. Tough pass, too far out in front of Curran. Drexel getting a little sloppy here. Delaware has to take advantage as it goes out of bounds to the Hens.
And Denise Dillon not happy with Brown. She gave her an earful over there on the sideline, not happy with that mistake.
Here comes Delaware, still looking for their first points out of the locker room. Gonzalez near wing to Brown. Brown dribbling towards the top of the key, turns the corner to the right elbow to Gonzalez. Pass for the corner, went off the hands of Drexel. They were looking for Jardine. It'll stay with the Hens as it hit the sideline. Couple of subs for the Dragons. Palacio back in playing with three now. And Ferrario, who was impressive in that first half, a true freshman from Romania.
Yeah, she's really been impressive, and Plecchio has been so important to this team this year. Really had some unbelievable offensive games.
Brown, left wing triple, wide open, wouldn't go. Nicholas had the rebound, knocked out of her hands, but it'll stay with the Hens as it goes to the baseline. Delaware will throw it in baseline right.
Yeah, if Delaware could get some good looks from the post, maybe get a foul or two, get some three-point plays that way instead of taking long perimeter shots.
Inbound comes from Erica Brown, lobbing corner to Anabosi. Left wing give to Bailey Cargo, who just came in. Up top to Nicholas into the corner. Brown driving baseline, nowhere to go. Lobbed it for Anabosi. It ended up in Nicholas's hand. She gives to Cargo. Off the dribble, pull-up jumper, partially blocked by Curran. Hit the front rim, and then Curran grabbed the rebound. So Drexel up 19, has held Delaware without a point first 3 minutes of this third quarter. Not playing well offensively, but digging in on the defensive end. Ferrariu working her way to the foul line and got bumped and fouled by Cargo. That'll be the second team foul on Delaware.
That'll be an interesting matchup if Cargo gets placed on Ferrario again, because Ferrario pretty savvy and could go left or right.
Runner threw some screens as she stuck on Palacio here, but good job by Cargo to fight over the top of it, forced the catch about 30 feet for the basket. Palacio dribbling between the circles. 6 3/4 minutes left, third period. Bounce pass left wing to Creighton. Off the high screen, step back, deep of deep three, would not go. Anabosi had the rebound, knocked out of her hands. Should have been a foul, but if you don't call the foul, it clearly went off of Anabosi out of bounds, but they'll split the difference and give the ball to Delaware.
I think that's exactly what happened. And you know what else, thinking back to that second quarter, you know, Creighton went out pretty early, and Drexel was able to extend their lead, so that's unbelievable.
And she picked up her second foul early stage of the second quarter, and that's when Drexel excelled. Here's Brown off the dribble, just beyond the elbow, jumper is good. It's a 17-point game.
You think of some of the offensive outputs that Delaware's had over this win streak, and just struggling to put points up on the board with only 24 here halfway through the third.
Anabosi has 10, nobody else with more than 5. Palacio off the dribble, straight away, triple wouldn't go. And Nicholas grabs the rebound, spins her way out of traffic, finds Brown across the timeline. Can Delaware string together some momentum? Brown, top of the circle, between the legs with a bounce, dribbling near wing, picks up her dribble, gives to Nicholas, swings it right wing to Jardine. Jardine directing traffic, bounce pass, corner to Anabosi. and Ebosi. Bounce pass, right block. Nicholas creates space, gets fouled as Curran hit her on the way up. And Nicholas heads to the stripe for a pair.
Great patience there, I thought, with Nicole and Ebosi trying to establish position. It wasn't there. Hannah Jardine has it on the wing, trying to get it to her. She pops out to the corner, allows Makeda Nicholas to dive. And then they had patience as well. And Nicole Nabosi with a great entry pass to Makeda Nicholas.
Talk about improvement. Nicholas is now 37 of 47 from the free throw line this year. She hits her first. She spent much of last year mired near 50% from the strike. So that is impressive. Second foul shot around and through. And it's 41-26. Four straight for the Hens. Here they go. Can they make the run?
If you remember, in that second quarter, they got within 15 with about 2 minutes to go. And we were saying if they could cut it, you know, and get it a little bit closer to 10. Well, now's their opportunity to get a stop and start creeping in a little bit more.
Ferrario, straightaway triple, no good. And a Bosi to rebound. That couldn't have been the shot that East Dillon was looking for. Here comes Brown the other way. A little gallop in her step. Works her way left elbow. Up top, Nicholas. Right wing give to Jardine. Bounce pass corner to Anabosi. Anabosi driving baseline and was bumped and fouled. And so the Hens will get possession. Good thing. A bailout call because Anabosi had absolutely nowhere to go.
Yeah, and what's starting to happen now is Drexel has three fouls on them in this quarter. If Delaware can keep attacking, maybe they can get some extra points, get them up to that five foul mark, and get some more free throw opportunities.
So the foul on Greenberg, her second. Brown will throw it in baseline left, gets a corner to Nicholas. Right wing feed to Cargo. Cargo backing up near center court, gives it to Brown in front of her head coach along the far sideline. Stagnant offense right here for Delaware. Now they get into something, a little high screen. Brown gets bumped, swings left wing Jardine. One dribble, entry feed Anabosi, and she is fouled as she spun on Bailey Greenberg. And that was a meat grinder of a possession, but it ends with another foul and another trip to the stripe for UD.
And this is why Delaware has won six in a row. They've pounded it into the paint, allow the bigs to establish, and Nicole Anabosi about to try to pull in a little bit closer to Drexel.
Time out on the floor, 4:54 left to go in the third quarter. Drexel 41, Delaware 26. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at
$22,500. What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
is at the free throw line shooting a pair. And a first foul shot around and out. Nicole Adebosi missing the first. She'll get one more. The foul was on Greenberg. It was her third and the team's fourth. So the Hens will shoot the final 4:54 of this third quarter. Adebosi hits the second. We got a 14-point game.
And the Hens have missed a few free throws, but they've gotten there 14 times in this game. Drexel only getting to the line four.
Delaware does not have a field goal here in a while. Drexel doesn't have any points, and now the foul away for the ball as Cargo got a piece of Pellecchio who fell awkwardly in some pain as she's helped up by her teammates. But she landed on that hip and kicks and tries to get the pain to go away. Second foul on Cargo, third on Delaware.
Yeah, I think her knee might have slammed against the floor as well, and Cargo was trying to bump her as she cut, but gave a little too much of an extension.
Inbound to Kern, spinning on Nicholas. Top fadeaway, good. What a shot by Sarah Kern. It's 43-27.
Yeah, Sarah Kern's been such a solid player for this Drexel team. We mentioned two-time first-team All-CAA, probably be a third in a row, and she's been a staple for this program.
Dardine near wing into the corner to Cargo. Up top, Dardine. Gives it to Nicholas, swings it foul line right to Brown. Brown, nice skip pass, Cargo, open three near corner, in and out. Boy, the iron has been unkind to Delaware as well. Rebound Creighton, here she comes the other way. Finds a trailing Pellecchio, back rims the three, hustling in, it's Brown. Her shot wouldn't go. Jardine the rebound this time for Delaware. Heads trailing by 16 with the ball. Brown across the timeline for UD, works her way to the paint, got stripped of the way up, got it back, banked it too hard off the glass. Curran grabs the ball.
And Delaware just can't find anything. Even when they're getting into the rim, they've missed a ton of layups and little chippies here today, and you just can't do that against Drexel. They're so efficient.
3:33 left third quarter. 43-27, Drexel's lead. Backdoor cut, Pellecchio got it. Missed the layup, got the rebound, but Woods couldn't finish. Out to Creighton, her straightaway triple, around and out. And a Bolsey the rebound for Delaware. 3:17 left. Hens down 16 with the ball. Brown across the timeline. Stopping top of the key. Handing to Jardine. Into the corner to Nicholas. Nicholas to Brown. Foul line right. Steps into a deep two. Wouldn't go. Nicholas, the offensive board, got bumped. No call, but banked it home. 43-29. 3 minutes left of the third.
And that's the difference, because when Delaware's make it, they've gotten the ball down near the block, just like McKenna Nicholas has, but she was able to make that shot.
Continuing to get some stops. Got to keep stringing them together and hope the offense will heat up. Drexel has no field goals in their last seven tries from the floor. Pellecchio top of the key, working her way right of the lane. Fade away, blocked by Adebosi, out of bounds. I guess it wasn't blocked by Adebosi. They say Delaware ball. Denise Dillon palms in the air, but it must not have hit the fingertips of Adebosi. Woods tried to save it, so the Hens get it. Down by 14, a chance to keep chipping away.
And I was actually surprised. I was thinking to myself, why is Woods saving this ball? Because it definitely was a blocked shot. So I'm not exactly sure about that call there. Great for the Hens, though.
Woods fooled the official. Here's Delaware in possession. Brown top of the key. Dribbling near wing. Picking upper bounce. Giving to Gonzalez into the corner for Jardine. It was tipped away. They are cheating so hard against Hannah Jardine. They're going to let anybody else shoot a three but her.
And I think Hannah, if she takes one step, she probably could make a backdoor cut there and take that little short corner shot.
They're overplaying her outside now, try to go to the basket. Gonzalez gets the inbound pass, dribbling foul line right. 8 to shoot, up top to Chapman, hands it to Brown. 5 to shoot, top of the key, works her way to the free throw line, out to Gonzalez, right wing 3, back rim no. Jardine, the weak side rebound, got bumped, spun out of traffic, works it all the way to the perimeter, and gets it to Brown. Great hustle by Jardine.
And the fans letting her know how much they appreciate that hustle. Really important possession here for the Hens.
Gonzalez has Jardine, deep two from the corner. Good, Hannah Jardine! Gets the Hens back within a dozen with 1:45 to go in the third.
Did you see that pass? What a pass by Gonzalez. She had to get that through two people.
Curran misses a three, but a weak side rebound by Woods. Bounce pass to the opposite block. Goes to Curran, up top to Creighton for a reset.
That was a tough angle for Abby Gonzalez. She actually kind of had to awkwardly take that shot. That was a fantastic pass.
It really was. It got Delaware within 12. Now they need to stop again. Woods along the baseline to Creighton, left wing. Creighton yet to put it on the deck, now does. Dribbles towards the top on a pick and roll, can't find anybody. Goes to Curran, and she walks. Delaware got out on the jump shooter. Curran tried to show the ball and blow past, but was late putting it on the floor. And the ball goes back to the Hens, a chance with a perimeter jumper to get it to single digits.
And the defensive effort here by the Hens, they've only given up 4 points here in the third quarter against a very good offensive team.
67 seconds left of the third. Brown, a bounce pass for Gonzalez on the near wing, dribbling towards the top, works away to the foul line, in some trouble, finds Abby on the right wing, into the corner, Jardine. Jardine, entry feed to Chapman, triple team, tries to dribble through it, step back jumper short, and Ebosi tipped the rebound, but Ferrario grabbed the board. Boy, somebody has to be open when there's three defenders in front of you.
Yeah, there was a tough possession there. Erica Brown wide open on the ball reversal.
I just got to find a way to kick that one out. I know Drexel's long and tries to take away your vision, but three within 3 feet of you. Curran on the far wing, dribbling towards the baseline, tried to split the double, got tripped. The good news is it was on the pass, so it'll be a possession foul. Or will it? Oh, my goodness, they're giving her shots.
Wow.
No, now the official's saying she passed the ball, I believe.
Yeah, that's on the floor. That's on the floor. He's overruling her. Oh my goodness. No way. Wow.
She passed the ball to the wing.
Wow.
It never went anywhere near the basket. Wow. Two free throws for Curran. And it rattles home to the lead back to 13, 44-31. The good news for Delaware, they'll get a possession out of this. Saw the replay on Hens All Access. If you're watching online, Ferrario ended up with the ball 30 feet from the basket.
Yes, they were saying, the one ref came over and said, no, she was flicking it upward, and because of the trip went out. But I'd say that's on the floor. But
second free throw is good. The ball doesn't go out to the wing. Here's Gonzalez dribbling across the timeline. Hens can hold for one. Really need a bucket here to get a little momentum back. And Ebosi turn and face. Hands to Brown. Brown works her way right of the lane. Lost possession. Out of bounds. Not sure where they're going with 14 seconds left, but a chance to hold for one. Gargo will return. And Brown will check out. 45-31. 14 seconds left. And Drexel gets an extra possession.
And I think she was coming off that handoff and just had nowhere to go. And instead of pulling up with nowhere to go, she kind of, I don't know if she'd lost control of the basketball or was trying to make a pass, but there was no one there.
Curran in the corner, step back, deep two, front rim, no, and a post of the rebound, and that's the end of the third quarter. The good news for Delaware, they played great defense in that third quarter. The bad news for Delaware, they were only able to trim a 17-point deficit down to 14. After three, Drexel still holding a 45-31 advantage. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOP.
Brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow.
I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming.
Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Some of the post players have been getting pushed off the block and they're receiving the ball a little bit too far outside. Pound it in, establish position, and get it where they can do something with it around the rim.
Hens ball to start the second half. Chapman up top, near wing to Jardine, up top to Cargo. Cargo on the far wing, dribbling towards the corner. Lost the handle, got it back. Great defense from Creighton. Just out of playing with her, knocked it off her leg out of bounds. The ball goes to Drexel. That's a fifth-year senior against a true freshman. Bailey Cargo is going to be a heck of a player, but Creighton kind of guiding her exactly where she wanted her to go.
Yeah, especially in that zone, they want you to go to the baseline. That's where they can either trap you, and then the rotation doesn't really allow you to see outside of that.
Tough matchup for Delaware. Here's Brown trying to drive, split through a double team, dished it off to Woods. Woods lost it. The great hustle by Ferrari, who diving to the deck. She got it. What happened? The official blew the whistle. Are they calling a walk or a jump ball? Walk. Tina Martin out near center court, giving her 2 cents, and she got the call. The ball goes back to Delaware as Gonzalez checks out, or Cargo checks out. And Brown returned.
And that's the right call. She rolled with the ball. If you roll on the ground, Ferrara takes it and spins around. That's a travel.
Here's Gonzalez working her way inside the arc, giving right wing to Brown. Brown dribbling towards the top. Gives to Jardine, foul line left. Jardine bounce pass up top. Anabosi gives to Chapman. Chapman being grabbed and fouled by Curran. That's a first team foul on Drexel in this fourth quarter. 9:01. Left to play. Delaware down by 14 as Bailey Greenberg will return. Sarah Woods out for Drexel.
And that's a good possession. I mean, the Hens are just running out of time a little bit, but that's exactly what you want to do. Make them foul you. Establish such good position. They have to climb over top of you to get the ball.
Boy, Jardine flashed wide open down the lane. They didn't see her. Instead, they get it to Anabosi. She drives, can't find the bounce off the backboard. And a shot missed. Rebound grabbed by Creighton for Drexel.
Such a great take, and there's been so many of those plays tonight where Delaware just hasn't been able to finish.
Here's Creighton in some trouble. Good defense by Gonzalez. Forced the dish. Ferrari, who has it out near center court, driving on Anabosi off a high screen. Chapman switches on her. The give goes up top to Greenberg. Greenberg gives it back to Brown. Brown driving to the lane. Missed the shot. Long rebound. Chased down by Anabosi. She wants to run. Had it knocked out of her hands from behind. Then got bumped by Ferrari right in front of us. And Anabosi sent sprawling, but pops up. Oh, the beauty of youth. That'll be a foul on Ferrari, the second team foul against Drexel in this fourth quarter.
You know, Nicole Anabosi loves to put the ball out in front of her and run in transition, and lost control, kind of got bailed out by Ferraro, actually, because I thought she was having a little trouble handling the ball, but Drexel already with two team fouls, so that's a good sign for Delaware. If they can get a couple more, then they're shooting on every foul.
Inbound to Gonzalez up top. Right wing feed to Brown. Got to start to pick up the pace on these possessions. Yep. Anabosi on the baseline. Step back, now drive, spins into a double, and Ferrariu came over to Fowler. Boy, that would have been perfect defense if she stayed straight up, but came past parallel. And that's an automatic foul call and two free throws for Anabosi.
And that's two fouls on Ferrariu in about 10 seconds.
Denise Dillon didn't like the call, but that's a freshman mistake. I mean, it was great defense until she brought those hands down. First free throw, though, no good for Anabosi. Delaware just not doing itself any favors. You can't go up at a 45-degree angle, and even if Anabosi creates all the contact, that foul goes against the defender every time. And that's why Anabosi goes to the line so much. She understands those things as well as anyone. Second free throw. Gets the roll and hit the rim. Back rim, front rim, back rim, front rim, and through. 45-32, 13-point game, pressure from Delaware, and an ear steal. Nicholas deflected the pass, out of bounds to the sideline. 25 on the timer, 5 to get it across.
And Delaware just needs to be cautious. You don't want to have any silly fouls 90 feet from the basket. You want to be aggressive, but not overextend.
Want to make them take their time to get it across here. Creighton trapped in the backcourt. Great heady play, throwing over the top to Curran. That was a much tougher pass, but they had no more time. Brown, right wing triple. That was not a good shot, but long rebound grab by Creighton, and that's a killer. That's been kind of the story of the day.
Yeah, Drexel just, you know, they're a senior-led team. They understand the game of basketball. This group has played in really big games. They have a lot of experience. So when it comes to end-of-game type situations, Creighton, Curran, Pelecchio, they've been around the block.
Brown, far wing, eight to shoot. High screen comes, works to the top of the key, tries a lob inside, stolen away by Gonzalez. She got stripped. They call a kick ball on Gonzalez. The ball goes back to Drexel. Tough break for the Hens. Gonzalez sprawling after it. They set her leg on a kicking motion. Got a piece of the ball. Oh, that's terrible.
Oh, my goodness. That's awful. What a horrible call.
Showed the replay on Hens All Access. It did touch her foot as she bent down to pick it up.
But they called the foul way after that. After she already tried to toss it to Erica Brown. Horrible call there.
The inbound goes to Creighton. Creighton fadeaway jumper, no good. Nicholas the rebound. Plus, it's allowed to touch your foot.
Right.
You're just not allowed to kick it. Gonzalez working her way across the timeline into the lane. Out of control. Runner wouldn't go. Rebound Greenberg. Here comes Drexel up 13. 7:04 to go, fourth quarter. And the Dragons, they'll be smart here. They'll work clock. Kind of the nature of their offense. That's what makes them tough to come back again.
Yeah, they have the ability to just run people off screens and then take the ball to the basket like Creighton did just there.
Flew right past the perimeter defense. 47-32, 6 3/4 minutes remaining. Delaware across the timeline with Gonzalez coming near wing. She's frustrated. You can see it on her face.
Yeah.
Up top to Chapman. Right wing swing goes to Nicholas. Nicholas works to the free throw line, threw it away. Tipped by Greenberg, stolen by Creighton, and Drexel walk it up.
At this point of the game, you just cannot have turnovers like that. You don't want to panic, but you have to have a sense of urgency and get to the rim. What was working so well for them in the first 3 minutes of this quarter?
Brown thought about a three, got the defender in the air, got past Anabosi, kicked it out to Greenberg. Right wing three is good, and that might be a dagger. Drexel back up 18 with 6:05 to go.
Yeah, it's been a tough spot for Delaware on that ball reversal. They've been kicking it out or reversing the basketball, and Greenberg's been wide open a few times on the right side of the floor at the wing.
Just have not been able to string together much of a run. Brown inside the arc, hits the straightaway jumper, and it's 50-34, but they've either strung together a bunch of stops and been unable to score, or when they do score the ball, Drexel's answer. And a tough day, a frustrating one. Can't win every game. But boy, was this an opportunity for Delaware to create some space between themselves and Drexel in that battle for the eventual three seed. Here's a drive by Brown into Erica Brown, who slid in late and is called for the block. And it'll be, I believe, two free throws. We'll have to wait and see whether they say in the act of shooting or not. Oh, they call offensive foul!
There was no motion whatsoever made when that play happened. I don't know what, if he was thinking about it on the way. I mean, I don't.
Oh, that's
wow.
Terrible.
See, I think he was going to call it on Erica Brown because he looked down at her, and now I'm wondering if he's going to get overruled.
Nope.
Wow.
That is good for Delaware.
And great for Delaware.
That's all I'm going to say.
You remember in the first half when we said this was a pretty well officiated game?
That
boy,
fell apart a bit.
There's been some calls here in the second half. I mean, and actually Delaware has benefited from them, but there's been some tough calls.
Here's Anabosi driving right in the lane, banks it home. We'll see. Hens can take advantage. Four straight back to within 14. 5:10 left of the fourth quarter.
And I think what's a little more troubling for Delaware is just not that they're losing this game, you know, not that they've had the step, but they're doing some things that they have not done over the stretch of the six-game winning streak, and that's a little troubling. You want to make sure you're still sharp.
Curtin driving on Nicholas, shot way too strong off the window. Rebound Jardine, still time. Hens got to hurry. 4:48 to go, down 14 with the ball. Gonzalez to the near wing, handing to Brown. Brown towards the top, gives it to Nicholas, lob to Anabosi, great catch, got bumped, no call, got it back, got stripped, and Curran the steal. First one, some contact, second one was clean.
Thought that was a great pass by McKenna Nichols. I don't know how it got there, but it was because she had two people on her, but really good pass.
And the Hens are playing a packed-in zone against a packed-in zone, and they're 1 of 11 from 3, and the entry feeds have just been so tight, the windows. Here's a lob over the head. of Bailey Greenberg out of bounds. It'll go to Delaware when we return. Still time, but starting to run out. 4:16 left of the fourth. Drexel 50, Delaware 36. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Assists 14, 9, 16, 14, 17. Big difference tonight. Six assists, six team assists. So, again, an assist is an important stat because it takes two people, someone to make the pass and someone to knock down the shot. And there's been a little bit of deficit on both sides here today.
And normally, when you get an assist, that means it's good ball movement.
Yep.
You're forcing the defense to work a little harder. 4:07 and ticking as Abby Gonzalez brings it into the front court. And it's got to be near flawless offensively now. Great lob inside Anna Bosey. Got fouled by Curran, who was late rotating over. Another nice feed from Nicholas. She is such a good high-low disher. And two free throws coming for Anna Bosey.
Yeah, and I thought when Anna Bosey took her last free throws, that the first one of the two, she almost short-armed it or kind of didn't go up on her toes the way she normally does. The second one, she got a little more of an arc. And that one much, much better. But I don't know, it was almost like she let it go too early. So it was a little bit of an awkward, but seems to be back to normal there. And Hens All Access showing us the entry pass from McKay to Nicholas. And I think that's why she's had some games where she's had 4 and 5 assists.
And Bosey makes the first, misses the second. Nicholas tipped the rebound, but Curran ran it down. Can't give away points at this point. 3:53 to go. Deficit remains 13. One of those days, it feels like, for Delaware. Creighton, step back, triple. No good. Brown twisted her ankle. Rebound tipped out of bounds. And it will be Drexel ball. Brown is slow to get up. Don't need to. The official should feel free to point a direction.
Erica Brown, you know, had some trouble with an ankle last year. It just seems to be a, no pun intended, an Achilles heel for her in some aspects. And the last thing you want is for her to turn her ankle before the JMU game.
Inbound goes to Woods. Woods goes to work. Banks at home, and it's 52-37. Well, they say once you sprain your ankle once,
yep,
always easy to keep on doing it. Jardine up top. Right wing to Gonzalez. Into the corner to Nicholas. Nicholas back to Gonzalez. 3:17 to go. To Brown, hands Jardine, left wing three, got it. Still a pulse for Delaware, 12-point game with 3:10 to go.
And I was going to say, in the the last possession. It seems like the Hens have not been able to break that 13 mark of the deficit. And well, here they are at 12 now with a little bit of hope and 3 minutes to try to get a miracle done.
Couldn't believe Creighton took that last three. 25 on the shot clock. He's a great three-point shooter, but time and score dictates not pulling the trigger there. And Denise Dillon was telling her work some clock on this possession. She has it far wing, stepping back, picks up her bounce to Pellecchio, lob inside to Curran. She's stripped by Anna Bosi, got the steal, fed it forward to Brown, racing to the bucket. She beats Woods, lays it home. 10-point game, 2:33 to go. Full court pressure from the Hens. Is there time? Back pass to Creighton. Creighton towards the timeline, bumped by Nicholas and fouled. Only the first team foul on UD. But that does reset the shot clock to 30.
I was actually going to say that right after they made that shot. I looked up and saw that Delaware had not committed any foul. So not a horrible foul there, except that it resets the shot clock.
You got to stop and score in a hurry at this point. Trap comes on Creighton. Creighton blows by on the baseline. Gives it to Curran. Curran dribbling towards the far wing. Picks up her bounce, hands to Creighton. 15 on the timer. 2:09 to go in the game. Delaware down 10, Drexel the ball, Curran far corner, driving on Jardine, step back, fade away, wouldn't go, and Abosi and Woods fight for it, tie up, arrow belongs to Drexel.
That's where those possessions are just so, so valuable. They got her to take the shot they wanted her to take, a little bit off balance, a tough shot. They had that rebound, Nicole had it, but Drexel able to tie him up.
Just have not been able to secure the boards cleanly as often as they have over the course of this six-game winning streak, and it has hurt Delaware because not only has Drexel gotten extra opportunities, but I think it's worn the Hens down. They got to play 30 more seconds of defense here. They don't really have 30 seconds at this point. 1:40 left of the clock, 10 on the timer. Creighton blows past Nicholas, layup wouldn't go, and Abosi lost the rebound. Curran grabbed it, puts it home, and that might do it. 12-point game, 90 seconds left.
And Curran just ripping the ball right out of Abby Gonzalez's hands there and getting that easy bucket.
Great screen from Jardine, freed up the Hens, and Abosi driving to the bucket, lays it home, left hand. Timeout, Delaware, 1:20 left, 10-point game.
What body control by Nicole Anabosi. She swung through on the left side, but because of the help side defense, she could not keep it in her left hand to just go up against the glass. So she then put it in her right hand and kind of twisted to block the defense. It was a great, great shot. What an athletic move.
First time out of the second half, so we'll take it with the Hens. 1:20 left. Drexel 54, Delaware 44. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball at Fox Sports 12, 90 and 14, 10 WDOB.
Brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at
$22,500. What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward. It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Day for Delaware. Delaware. They trail Drexel 54-44. The Hens 2 of 12 from 3, 15-43 overall. And getting out-rebounded by the Dragons. 15 offensive boards for Drexel, plus 4 overall on the glass. It's a bad combination. Inbound here for Drexel. Creighton gets it in. Gives it to Brown. Brown splits a double team and a bounce pass forward to Pelecchio. Pelecchio gives to Creighton out near center court. Hens look like they're going to play it out one more time. Down by 10. Still 16 on the timer. 105 left in the fourth quarter. Hens have 3 fouls to give here. Creighton dribbling near the center court stripe. Spinning back. Double comes. Fed it through. Back line wide open. Brown missed the layup. And it'll late whistle and a foul called on Delaware. It's a good call. Anabosi, the foul, it was just a very late foul. 2 free throws coming for Drexel.
And that, you know, that's the same gentleman that never made the offensive signal for the offensive foul that we were all wondering about. Just like you said, not a horrible call, but make the call. And now they're going to look to the monitor what to see if she got hit in the head. Oh, my goodness.
I have maybe a timing issue. I'm not sure what
I
that
hope
one
it's a timing
be.
Issue and not because that was
the buzzer sounded, which I think was the scores table alerting they needed the official to come over and look at something. That's an assumption on my part. I did hear that buzzer. 48-5 is what it says right now. 54-44. Reminder, the Blue Hens basketball brought to you by St. Francis Healthcare, the official hospital of Delaware Athletics. At St. Francis Healthcare, they provide a higher level of care to better serve Blue Hens fans and the community. Learn more about the official hospital of Delaware Athletics at stfrancishealthcare.org. So whatever it was, the officials have seen it. They move forward. It was an undercut, it looked like, by Anabosi. Just got a little piece of her, but
I don't see what, I mean, I'm hoping it was a timing issue because
I
don't
understand the shot.
Oh, my goodness.
Saw the inbound. It was a clock issue. They moved it up to 52. Delaware is not going to foul, so that means this game is over. 54-44, 42 seconds of ticking, double team in the corner, timeout called by Drexel. But when not fouling, you're down to 41 seconds to go, down by 10. Pleased with their team's effort, I think, in the second half. They played very hard. Janine Reddy's talked about the concentration wasn't fully there in the first half. I could see what she meant by that. I think it was there in the second half. The execution, unfortunately, was not against a very well-coached and a very much experienced and talented Drexel team.
Yeah, this Drexel team has been in huge games this year. You know, they took women's basketball by storm when they opened up against Penn State. Penn State being a little bit of a down year for them, but you didn't know that right away, but they blow them out. They beat number 11 Syracuse, and everybody's like, whoa, look at Drexel. So they've had some good things going on for them this year.
Nicholas gives the foul. 38 seconds left on the inbound. Hard foul. Third team foul, so still one more to give for Delaware.
And you want to make sure you're going for the ball. You don't want to just foul the foul. Go for the ball. You don't want to make too hard of fouls to make it look like you're just trying to, you know, knock someone over. Make a good foul. Go for the ball.
I don't really know what fouling does at this point. 32 seconds to go. Down by 10, but they give it out near center court. Gonzalez on a contact. 29-7 to go. It's a fourth team foul. One more. I think Tina Martin saying, calm down. No more fouls now. The inbound goes to the backcourt to Creighton, and Creighton can dribble it out.
Yeah, and here you don't want to make any silly fouls to make it more than 10 points. So, and if you're Drexel, you're just going to dribble it out. There's no need to do anything.
Well, they can't win them all. Delaware's 6-game winning streak will come to an end. The Hens will still be tied for third in the CAA, which is good. Unfortunately, they'll be a half game kind of behind Drexel because they hold the tiebreaker. The Dragons end Delaware's winning streak, snapping it at 6 straight and coming to the bob and beat Delaware 54-44 as the final horn sounds. Drexel improves to 7-4 in conference play. Delaware drops to the same record. We'll take a break, come back with a post-game show in a moment. Drexel beating the Hens, much to the chagrin of Hens head coach Tina Martin. You're listening to Blue Hens Fast.
By 7 senior West Shore. guard, 5'6" senior, out of Lebanon, New Jersey, number 23, Jessica Colecchio. And forward, 5'11" senior, out of Media, Pennsylvania, number 33, Sarah Curran. Coach UCF for Drexel University, coordinator of basketball operations, Taylor Uchin. Assistant coaches for Stacey McCullough, Michelle Baker. Associate head coach, Amy Allen. And ladies and gentlemen, her 14th season at Drexel University, the head coach, Denise Tillman.
Assisted by Janine Redis, Tom Latner, Dave Singleton, and Kayla Miller. Delaware in the home white jerseys today. Yellow script letters across the chest spell out Delaware. Yellow numbers on the front and backs of the jerseys. Drexel in the road, navy blues. Yellow letters across the chest spell out Drexel. Yellow numbers on the front and back. Delaware will move from left to right. We are underway this rivalry game. The tip won by the Hens. Hannah Jardine ends up with it, gives it to Erica Brown, and Brown will dribble it across the timeline. Angling towards the far wing, picking up her bounce, lobbing left block to Anabosi. Opposite wing feed to Jardine. Deep two, front rim no. Nicholas hustles down the offensive board. Another try for Delaware.
Very interesting to see Drexel come out in the man-to-man defense, not the zone.
They struggled in that zone against Charleston, so switching it up is an entry feed for Anabosi. That was tipped aside. Good hands by Greenberg. Knocked it to the baseline. 18 still to shoot for Delaware. 30 seconds in, and neither team has scored.
Great movement so far on the offensive end by Delaware.
Lob to Brown, top of the key. Brown works her way to the free throw line. Gives just inside the arc to Nicholas. Left wing jumper, no good. Weak side rebound corralled by Creighton. She'll bring it forward. Feeds to Pelecchio on the left wing. Pelecchio picks up her bounce. Up top, Greenberg. Hit fake the three. Hands to Creighton, and she'll get reorganized.
Three-point defense, perimeter defense is so important in today's matchup.
Creighton, the fifth-year senior, bounce pass left elbow to Greenberg, attacking on the bounce against Anabosi, too strong with a shot off the window, rebound grabbed by Nicholas, that lets it forward to Gonzalez, looking to push up the far sideline, angling towards the wing, directing traffic, picks up her bounce, chest pass top of the key to Jardine, near wing give over to Brown, up top to Anabosi, looking inside for Nicholas, instead hands it to Gonzalez, works her way inside the arc to the free throw lot, out to Brown, lob entry, Anabosi bump, no call, banks it home anyway. Heads up, 2-0.
Great body control there by Nicole Anabosi to not get knocked off. I kind of like that the refs are letting them play a little bit here early in the game.
That's the way Delaware Drexel should be.
Creighton, bounce pass, foul line left to Greenberg. Surveys her options, still 15 to shoot. Up top, gives to Brown. Brown swings it right wing to Pellecchio. Pellecchio to Creighton, top of the key. Curran and face, gives to Curran on the baseline, left side of the floor. Jumper wouldn't go. Around and out, rebound Anabosi. Outlets it up to Brown, again looking to push. Attacking towards the lane, kicks it out to Gonzalez, who bobbled, recovered, and sets up the offense.
That last possession, perfect example. McKinnon Nicholas going over top of that screen, but you have to trail Curran.
Lob taken away. They tried to get it to Anabosi from Nicholas up top. Good steal by Greenberg, who was fronting in the post. Creighton brings it forward, hits a trailing Greenberg, straightaway triple, air ball. She missed the rim wide to the right on an open jumper, and it's out of bounds to Delaware.
Now, this is Bailey Greenberg's first experience with this rivalry. She's had a great season. I actually was at their Niagara Drexel game visiting a former assistant coach here at Delaware, now a head coach, Jada Pierce, at Niagara, and Kelly Greenberg was fantastic in that game.
Greenberg on the year averaging better than 8 points, 4.5 rebounds per game, starting to understand the offense better as well. We mentioned a career-high 4 assists in that loss against Charleston. She has 11 assists over her last 3 games.
And I'll tell you what, if Delaware on defense, if they go over top of those baseline runners, Drexel will kill them from the corners. They have to trail.
McCoy and Abosi was tying her shoe. The reason for the delay, we return to action. 7:32 left, opening quarter. Delaware up 2-0. Brown with it in the forecourt. Dribbling top of the key. Works her way right of the lane. Pull up jumper. Good. High arcing shot from Brown. Gives Delaware a 4-0 lead.
Yeah, Delaware making some really good decisions here. And I like already the inside out. Kind of the jump shots, but then also pounding it into Nicole and Abosi. And I think they can really be effective in the post. They have a size advantage.
Fourth straight game where Delaware has gotten off to a very fast start. We'll see if they can keep it going. Here's Brown, top of the key, handing to Pellecchio. Pellecchio looking for Creighton. Creighton backing up near wing. Dribbles to the free throw line. Gives to Curran, top of the circle. Curran in some trouble. Back to Creighton. Straightaway triple. That one's good. A 47% three-point shooter. She shows why. Drexel on the board. Back to within one.
And again, often Drexel plays that four out, one in, and everyone can shoot from the three, and you cannot try to block their jump shot. They will take one side step, just like Creighton did, and nail it.
Quick trip to the man, back to the zone for Drexel. Gonzalez tries to shoot over the top of the left wing. Air ball's a three. Curran, the weak side rebound. She'll bring it up for herself. Sarah Curran leaves it for Creighton across the timeline. Center of the floor, giving near wing to Brown. Brown jab step on Jardine with Delaware in the man. Dribbling towards the top. They swing it right wing to Curran. Curran yet to put it on the deck. Cross court skip pass to Greenberg. Greenberg head fake to three, driving on Anabosi. She blocked her shot out of bounds. It'll stay with Drexel. You can see the game plan for the Dragons. They want to try to get Nicole Anabosi some early fouls.
And I thought that was pretty good recognition by Bailey Greenberg to realize who was guarding her, realize there was a lane there to the left and trying to take Anabosi. And again, I like that the refs are letting them play. A little bit of contact, but they're letting them play.
Greenberg out. Sarah Woods in for the first time. Inbound to Pellecchio. Five to shoot through the lane. Runner off the window and through. Nice move by Jessica Pellecchio. And Drexel, their first lead of the game.
Yeah, Pellecchio doing a nice job off the dribble there, and I thought she was missed. Creighton missed her early. She was wide open for a three, but she got hers anyway.
Dragons up 5-4. Brown with it near corner. Dribbles towards the wing. Up top to Jardine. Left wing give to Gonzalez. Dribbles to the free throw line. Pass deflects off Anabosi. To Brown. Corner three. Back rim no. Jardine up high. Grab the rebound in traffic and resets it out to Brown.
Yeah, Drexel now in kind of more of a matchup zone again. They're one of their trademarks. I think you got to pound it in. Look for the flash and pound it in.
Jardine on the wing, giving near corner to Gonzalez. Up top, Nicholas. Nice entry feed to Anabosi. Spinning away for the defense. Got fouled as she went up with a shot. And will head to the line to shoot two. That is a nice piece of ball movement from Delaware, reversing and getting inside.
I think Delaware doing a good job of balancing when to put the ball on the floor and kind of attack and pick versus, you know, reversing the basketball. And again, Delaware, what they've done so well over the last month of that high-low, the big-to-big pass. So great pass by Makeda Nicholas to Nicole Anabosi.
Anabosi hits the first free throw. She has established residence at the free throw line this season. That was her 158th foul shot attempted. This will be 159. That's 99 more than any other teammate. Second free throw, good. And it's 6-5. Delaware up a point.
And I think it's also a testament to how hard she works to establish position. And then the perimeter players recognize it, look for that high-low, or that entry pass, and that's why she's getting to the line.
5 1/4 minutes left in the opening period. Woods on the near wing, up top to Creighton. Right wing give to Brown. Brown puts it on the deck, driving on Jardine, spinning into the lane, kicking out. Left wing three for Kern is short. Jardine fighting for the rebound, had it knocked out of her hands, and Drexel ends up with it. Palacio for three, and that one's good. She's been on fire of late. And she hits another tray, 8-6 Drexel.
And that's what happens against Drexel. You feel like you're in control, you're doing great things on the offensive end, and then 2 3-point shots later, they're right back in it.
Palacio hit 7 trays in her last game against Talladega Charleston. Brown, top of the key, dribbling far wing. Jab step out to Jardine. Left elbow jumper for Nicholas. Her shot around and out. Woods the rebound. Here comes Drexel up 2, 4:24 left opening quarter. Creighton across the timeline, giving foul line right to Brown. Brown up top to Creighton. Left wing give to Woods. Woods, left hand dribble. Head fake. Nowhere to go. Gives to Brown, left wing. Brown with Jardine guarding her not closely. Up top to Palacio. Right wing to Curran. 9 on the timer. Back up top to Brown. Right hand dribble. Works her way to the free throw line. To Woods just inside the arc. Her air ball jumper off the foot of Nicholas, but it doesn't matter as the shot clock sounds, so the ball will go to Delaware when we return. Time out on the floor, 3:58 left to go in the opening period. Drexel 8, Delaware 6. You're listening to Blue Wings Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410.